Hey everyone, and welcome to the ENES 100 lab space. We're all very excited for you to be able to have the opportunity to come in and take advantage of all the different available resources and tools to work on and complete your projects. Now, before you come into the lab, there's a few things you need to do. Firstly, you need to check our course webpage and the office hours to ensure that the lab space is open and available for you to come in. To help us control the flow of students, we also ask that you complete a reservation, if necessary, and follow all the steps to do that. Secondly, we want to make sure that you are all safe in the lab and you're properly trained on our different protocols and procedures. So we ask that you complete all the required safety trainings and follow the guidelines that we set forth on the course webpage. We'll send out more information about this later. Last but certainly not least, we also ask that you follow all the guidelines set forth in return.umd.edu. All of this will help ensure that we've got a safe and productive lab environment for you to work on your projects. Now, this is all things you do before you come to the lab, but let me show you what you should do as you walk through our lab doors.
As you enter the lab, go over to the cabinet and grab a pair of safety glasses. Using the provided alcohol wipes located on the table by the entry, wipe your glasses thoroughly to sanitize them. Then use the same wipes to sanitize your workstation and any tools that you plan to use. To keep the floor tidy and prevent tripping hazards, use the provided hooks beneath the table to hang your belongings and keep them out of the way. Now that we've rated our workstation, let's take a look at some of the tools available in the shop. On each table, you'll find a variety of useful hand tools, like wire cutters, screwdrivers, scissors, clamps, wrenches, a ruler, and calipers. On the other side, you'll also find a number of other tools, like a power drill, drill bits, Allen wrenches, small screwdrivers, files, and a utility knife. On the back wall, you'll find that you also have access to a number of other hand tools and different measuring implements. You'll find a Dremel station with assorted attachments, and you'll also find a full-equipped soldering station that has all the things you might need, like solder, flux, helping hands, and assorted wire. There are also larger power tools like a drill press, a power sander, and a scroll saw for cutting woods and plastics. You'll also have access to a number of 3D printers via reservation. Simply visit the course webpage, complete the training, and set up a time to print your parts. The lab also has laser cutters, which can be used to quickly manufacture and engrave a variety of different structures using either acrylic or plywood sheets. In addition to the ENES 100 labs, you'll also be able to take advantage of other lab spaces like the wood shop, as well as the advanced manufacturing tools operated by Terrapin Works. These resources can be very useful if you plan to try and manufacture something particularly unique or sophisticated. You can find more information about these and other campus resources on our course webpage.
Well, there you have it, everyone. We hope you enjoyed this little overview of the different lab spaces, as well as the tools and resources that you have at your disposal this semester. And we're all very excited to see how you put them to good use. Now, before you go, I want to share with you some exciting news about a special project that our LTFs have been working on for quite some time. Hopefully, in the coming weeks, when you come to the lab, you'll have another impressive tool at your disposal.